Before you say what you need, because I know you're going to have comments on this, before you say what you need to say, listen to me lay all this crap out, all right? Double or Nothing sold out fairly quickly in fairly short order. That being said, I'll say this. They, and I've said this about WWE, because you and I have experienced scalpers in the past that just jack up prices ridiculously. The promoter doesn't care. I mean, sure, they'd like to have people in those seats, but as long as they have that sweet, sweet dollar in their pocket, they don't care. However, on the flip side, it was not all fans that bought these tickets. I have proof on my Twitter. A guy bought 4 tickets at a total price of $400, turned around and sold them, or is trying to sell them, for over $300 a pop.
Yeah.
That's stupid. And I retweeted, because this guy is trying to sell it on Twitter, and he's not just saying this, like, he had, like, actual proof. He blanked out his credit card information, but he had proof that he had the tickets, and he posted it, and he was like, if anybody wants to buy them off of me, it's this price. And I retweeted it, and I said, it's a-holes like this why we can't have nice things. And he said, oh, no, you can have nice things, but you gotta pay for them.
Well, he's not wrong, but...
Yeah, but it's like, still, man, what a dick. And he's not the only one. There are a lot of people out there like
that. I mean, I can't say anything otherwise, because, you know, same thing for WWE. And I would say exactly what you said, too. I mean, they sold them, so that's all that matters.
Exactly.
But...
Yeah, because, you know, I don't think Cody...
I mean, come on, though. People are not... I'm sorry. I don't believe people are traveling from Australia to come see this. I don't believe that. I think those were bought specifically to resell. But
quite possibly. Either that, or they had a... I mean, I could totally see them using this as an excuse. They're like, well, we've always wanted to go to Vegas. Let's go to the show while we're there. I could see...
No, it's very possible.
Yeah. I mean, Vegas is a vacation location, so... That's like you, if you want to, in the future, and I'm not trying to rub this in, I'm just bringing this up. In the future, you're like, yeah, I kind of want to go to Vegas, let's go see the Raiders while we're down there, you know what I mean?
That's going to be my reason to go, so, yeah.
Yeah, and I know you said
I'm saving a trip there for that, when they play the Chargers, so,
yeah,
that's my thing.
Screw the Chargers, by the way, but that's beside the point.
Well, hell yeah!
But, yeah, it just... Cody and the Bucks aren't sitting there like, oh no, some of these people might not show up that bought our tickets. They don't care. Same thing with, like...
Well, I mean, they might be, but not in that way.
Yeah, right.
I mean, it does kind of suck that they're trying to give them to actual... And I consider knock it all day, but...
Yeah.
There are people that legit want to go, and they weren't, you know, maybe they had, like, a life, and they had a job, and they couldn't be on the internet right there at 7 to grab them all, or... 10 Eastern, whatever it was, you know, so they couldn't get them all right away, and the idiots in their basements got them all.
Well, screw you, Greg, for having a life.
Hey, when I got my your WrestleMania tickets, I actually, full disclosure, I was at work, and I begged my coworkers, guys, I gotta step off for like 5 minutes. So you can do it still, but, you know, sometimes you can't. But,
right.
You know, point being, I can knock it all day, but it's not fair to be like, you know, they deserve it. They just screwed some fans out of going. That's messed up to me.
Yep.
You know.
I totally agree.
No, I'm not going to be... I don't want to be hypocritical on it, but WrestleMania is a different story. It's a huge show. So, of course, they're going to try to benefit off that. But this is like the first show. Why do it now? You know? I mean...
Because they did the same thing with All In. But now they're saying, oh, well, we know for a fact. Because with All In, they were hoping. With this one, they're like, well, we know for a fact people will want to go to this one. You know, it's the same... people that went to All In, generally speaking. So it was...
Well, I mean, yeah, but I don't think it was... I think there were still scalper problems with that, too. Even Uncle Dave said it.
Oh, with All In? Absolutely. Yeah, that's why I said it was... It was the same thing, but it's... I think it's on a bigger scale even now than it was even then, just because people know for a fact they can get money.
I just hate it. I think it's...
Yeah.
It's disgusting.
Two things in my opinion, I mean, ruined what we knew of the wrestling business from the past. Those two things being cable television, like, across the country, and, like, that completely... Because people say, well, Vince McMahon killed the territories. No, cable killed the territories. Let's be honest. The other thing is this crap right here. This didn't happen so much back in the 90s or whatever.
I would tie this with the internet, but yeah, right.
Yeah, the internet was a big deal too. And
well, I mean, like, this ties in with it though. I mean, this is all web-based.
Yep.
And it's just, you know, yeah, I want to sit here and talk crap about it, but I can't. It's you know, it's horrible.
Yeah, and it's I'm sure if there was,
I mean, I have my opinions on it, and like I've said, and I've stated them, but I it'll fail. People keep doing this crap.
Yeah. And I'm sure if there was...
Well, maybe it won't fail. They'll still get their money, but they're going to have empty houses if people are just sitting on tickets that they couldn't sell.
Right.
I mean...
Yeah, and the thing is, like, I'm sure if... Same thing with WWE. If they could do something about it, I'm sure they would try. But they're... I mean, what the hell are you going to do?
Well, here's the thing. They flat out partnered with StubHub. They're, in essence, encouraging it.
Wow. Okay, well, then I stand corrected.
I mean... It says it on their site, you know, official partner or StubHub's an official partner or vice versa, whatever.
Ugh.
Like, it's the official ticket resale thing. So
I feel that StubHub themselves should do something about crap like this.
Yeah, I mean,
there needs to be some kind of regulation. Yeah. That's all I'm saying.
You should see the WrestleMania ticket prices, man. It's crazy.
Oh, like,
and I get that it's New York. Okay, it's a bigger market, but hell no, man. No.
Well, I know what the trouble you went through in New Orleans just trying to get Raw and SmackDown tickets. So
yeah, I literally waited till like a couple of days before I flew out.
Yeah. You did with SmackDown, right? Yeah, with Raw, didn't you buy like day of or something?
I did. Yeah, but the SmackDown ones, that was a different story. Those were cheaper. But the WrestleMania ones, I got right away. So.
Right. Man.
And for the seats, you got the Hall of Fame. For only $80, clearly, you know, I got those day one.
Right.
I mean, those would have been like 400 or 500 piece easy, the ones we got.
Yep.
Resale value, I mean.
It's pathetic. But yeah, so there's that.
Also, I want to point out to anyone, the trick is to wait till later. The prices always go down.
There you go.
And someone will go unmentioned, but people who buy resale tickets need to learn this. You get them late.
I'm definitely going to do that from now on. I'm going to try to buy day of or the day before or something.
Yeah.
So, but either way, there's that. Also, with the sellout, I guess they have set records for that venue. So,
yeah, but
whatever that's worth.
That's a piss on it, but it is only 2 years old. So, that's.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if it was for the venue or for the city. I can't remember.
I know it was the first wrestling one. In Vegas.
Okay. Yeah, that might have been it.
I think UFC, the one with Connor and Khabib, I think it was that one. That's the gate holder, so.
Ah. Well, there you go.
No shock there, though.